authority. He says, arise and awake. And the Bible says, those who are dead and who have been faithful to their told truth. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. If the Son set you free, you shall be free indeed. Will you not say amen there?
Amen.
Why? When we are changed, I love this. He says, for this corruptible must put on incorruptible corruption, and for this mortal must put on immortality. Wait a minute. Anyone who says when you die, you are immortal, it's a lie. We are only immortal when Jesus will come. When Jesus comes to set up the kingdom of truth, this corruptible body will put on incorruption. This mortal body will put on immortality. At that time, there will be gladness. At that time, truth shall reign in the land. Philippians 3:20, we look for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall change our vile body. Who will change our body? Jesus. Why will he change our body? He wants us to stay with him for how long? Forever. That it may be fashioned like his own glorious body. At that time, two groups. Revelation says, two groups will be shown. Revelation 6 verse 14. And the heavens departed as a scroll when it is rolled together. And every mountain, when the Bible says every mountain, it means every mountain. An island, they were moved out of their place. There is confusion. There is disorder. The world is not normal anymore. And it says, and the kings of this earth and the great men and weak people again, and the rich man, and weak people again, and the mighty man. Wait a minute. Those who think they have power over us today, those who are godless, they've used every unbiblical way to make money. A day is coming. God says, you, the rulers of this world, you, the kings of this world, you, the great men of this world, you, the rich men of this world, you, the mighty men of this world, men who use their power, men who use their money to intimidate the poor. Revelation says, when God, truth will reign, when you take a case to God, a rich man will buy the judge. When your issue is right, because you don't belong to the gangs, your case is evil. A day is coming. And the Bible says, they will be shouting and saying, hid themselves, they will be hiding in the dens. Rich men who were in beautiful houses. It's good to be rich, but if your riches lead you to do evil, a day is coming. If your money, you didn't use it to propagate the kingdom of truth, a day is coming. If your influence never led people to Jesus, a day is coming. You'll be hiding in dens and in rocks and of mountains. And what will they be saying? And say to the mountains, how can you speak to an inanimate material? They will be saying to the mountains and to the rocks, fall on us, kill us, kill us. And have those who build houses and have tall walls and were afraid of armed robbers, they will tell the rocks, kill us. Oh, why? This is it. I'm coming this way. God hates sin. He wants to destroy sin. And if sin is in any container, God will destroy the container. Sin, let me give you an example. If you take a candle and you take a clay, if you put the clay under the sun, will it melt? No. It has the properties that will make the clay solidify. When you put a candle, you put it under the sun, it will do what? It will melt. These are the two groups of people. The sinners when they see the brightness of God, the same brightness that will make some leave, the same brightness is going to make them to say, hide us from the face of him that sits on the throne for the great day of his wrath. Jesus is not going to come like a child. He's going to come as the King of Kings, and he's going to come as the Lord of Lords. And there were noises and thundering and lightnings, and there was a great earthquake. How? Such a mighty and a great earthquake as had not occurred since men were on the earth. It is a terrible day. All those who sit at the nightclub and engage in immorality, it is a day. All the tribes of the earth, they will mourn. It is a day, Jesus said, will happen to those who are not ready for that day. Those who hate truth, those who detest truth, those who follow their pastors aside the Bible, those who follow their husband aside the Bible, those who follow their wives aside the Bible, those who follow their children aside the Bible, those who follow their mothers aside the Bible, all those who hate evil, they'll be running. He will come with blazing fire. And when God, his righteous beam, and nomos, his love, stream down the corridors of life, the brightness of his glory will destroy sinners. 2 Thessalonians 1 verse 7 and 8, and to give you who are troubled rest. Oh, a day is coming. My troubles in this life will come to an end. Nobody knows the trouble you go through. That tears, you cry for that husband because he can't love you. He's cheating on you. A day will come. God will give you rest.
Amen.
That struggle you go through in the street of Lagos, just to get food. And I was in the car, I nearly broke down in tears. When I was coming, I saw the way the young men were on the street, they were selling just to get food. Motor riders, everybody hustling. Jesus said, if you remain faithful, his coming will give you rest. Rest from the toils for your children. You are a single mother. You are taking care of the children alone. Nobody knows the trouble you go through. You are a young man. You need to take care of your siblings. Nobody knows. You are a graduate. You have been looking for a job. Only God knows how long. Nobody knows the trouble you are going through. And to give you rest, who are troubled with us, when the Lord Jesus is revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, but he will take vengeance on those who do not know God. Do you know God? Going to church is not knowing God. Listen to me tonight. In Matthew 7, verse 21, Matthew 7, verse 13, 14, up to verse 25, Jesus says, not everyone who say to me, Lord, Lord, will partake in this kingdom. He said, those who does the will of my Father, who is in heaven. Do you know God? Those who will not be burned, those who will not be destroyed, they are those who know God, and they are those who do not obey, and those who do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. They are those who, a decision will be called on you to make. Bible says, those who